completing your 2020 census?
How are you guys? Are you cooped up just like all of us? But you know what? The thing is, just because we're socially distancing ourselves doesn't mean we are disconnected, if you know what I mean. So I've been isolating, distancing. I'm here with my family though, live from our Lake Arrowhead cabin, everybody. Look, it's snowing outside. It's just gorgeous. And what I love about the silver lining with all of this, at least for me personally, is we're spending time with our family, we're eating together, we're cooking together. I am drinking alone, however, and I'm making a delicious quarantini today. I'd like to bring my lovely daughter on camera, Becca Jonas. Say hi, Becca.
Hi.
Becca's gonna be my sous chef today. My adorable husband, Matthew, is our camera operator. We have Dylan Jonas, Becca's twin brother, on hand here is our audiovisual sound technician. Along with that, we have our amazing director Rita Drucker. Say hi, Rita.
Hi, everybody.
Rita's joining us from Sherman Oaks, California, remotely. She'll be fielding all of your questions today and your comments, so please keep them coming. As I mentioned earlier, we're gonna be making a white bean chili today with turkey. It's a super easy recipe, and a lot of the ingredients you probably already have on hand in your pantry. A lot of you wrote to me earlier and said, oh my goodness, I couldn't find hominy. Totally fine. Just double up on the beans. As I said to Steve Patrick, maybe you should double up on the beans, if you know what I mean. Additionally, my friend Jean Wyman, who's either in Utah right now or Maryland, when shopping for today's lesson, she couldn't find any ground turkey or any ground meats of any kind, which I know a lot of you are facing this dilemma. So if you wanna make a completely vegetarian version of this dish, just double up on the beans. You could use vegetable broth instead of chicken broth. Another great idea would be to use Impossible Meat, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or Beyond Meat, if you've tried that. It's an excellent substitute. Just follow the directions. Oh, also, as a matter of fact, the recipe is currently on my blog, chefkatychin.com. Okay, I promised you a quarantini. What's a quarantini? Well, it's just a bit of vodka. We did not bring our martini shaker to Lake Arrowhead. So, you know what? In this time of lockdown and quarantining, if that's even a word, or socially isolating, you've got to improvise. So no shaker, I'm using a milk jug. So I have some of my most favorite vodka in here, Tito's. Is anybody online yet, Rita?
Oh boy, we have almost a full house.
Oh my gosh.
Tell ya. First of all, can you please say hi to Mary Furlow?
Hi, Mary Furlow.
Mark Rees, Valerie Schaefer,
hi, Mark.
Alan Schwartz.
Hi, Valerie. Hi, Alan Schwartz up in Canada.
Armita Gordon.
Armita.
And let's not forget, sister Laura Chen.
Hi, Laura Chen. Thanks for joining today. All right.
And Helene Mullen.
Hey, Mima. All right, we have some vodka in here, right? To this, I'm just going to add about 2 ounces of honey. This is our favorite raw, unfiltered honey, just for some sweetness. And why do we call this a quarantini? Does anybody know? Anyone? Becca?
Nope.
We put this away?
Sure.
Thanks. I'm gonna add some lemon juice. I'm adding a squeeze of lemon juice because lemons and lemon juice have immune boosting properties. That's why we wanna drink a lot of vodka with lemon juice, okay?
I don't think you'll have a problem with this crowd. I know. Think they're a vodka crowd.
I know, Rita, you wish you were here right now. Okay.
I mean, more so than, I think this is more appropriate for me than Becca.
I agree. Don't let your children do this at home. Okay, listen, because I'm just gonna shake this up. Again, I don't have any martini glasses here, so I have my adorable leopard spotted wine glass. I haven't had any of this. I promise, I received from Kathleen McMahon in Chicago. Maybe she's tuning in. Not sure. But if you are, hi, Katie McMahon from Chicago. Okay. I'm just going to pour some of my delicious quarantini into my glass. Then I'm going to add another squeeze of lemon juice. Remember, those citrus fruits are so great as an antioxidant, immune-boosting drink. Okay, ready? That is delicious. Okay, I'm going to put this aside. So let's just talk about the ingredients. And I so appreciate all of you that went out and went shopping for today's live stream. We're going to talk a little bit about the pepper. This is a poblano pepper. It's very large. It has a very thick skin, unlike me. It has a very thick skin. You can cut it in half and stuff it with delicious ingredients. I like to mince up some shrimp and onion and garlic, put it in there, put a little cheese and toss it in the oven. But we're going to just cut these up finely for our chili today. We also have some celery. And cooking under quarantine, you guys, is all about improvisation. So don't worry about it if you don't have certain things. If you don't have celery, just leave it out. It's no problem. Let's talk about fiber. Fiber is very important during these times. Okay, I know you're feeling desperate at the grocery store, but it's essential that you eat the rainbow and continue to eat fresh vegetables and fruits. And if you can't find fresh vegetables, load up on frozen veggies at the grocery store, okay? Then we have our white beans. These are cannellini beans, okay? Or white kidney beans. In addition, we have hominy. Does anyone out there know what hominy is? Please make a comment and let us know if you know what it is. I'll tell you the answer in a couple minutes, okay? We also have white onion. You could use a yellow onion. You could also use a shallot. Shallot is sort of like a combination between garlic and white onion, okay? We also have...
We have an answer on okay. What hominy means.
Who's that from?
That is from Marcus McGee. He says corn.
Hey, Marcus McGee. Yay! Ding, 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 ding.
She also said corn.
Whenever there's an answer, correct answer, do this. Ready? Ready? Okay, good job. Maybe not with a knife. Here, go get a spoon. Thank you. Okay.
Oh, wait. Neil Newman is getting very technical. It's corn soaked in a horticultural lime.
Ooh, Neil Newman, A plus. So, hominy is dried maize, dried corn. You're right, it is soaked in an alkali made of lime. That makes it nice and puffy, it's washed, and then actually, this is often then dried and ground, and that becomes maize that is used to make tortillas and such. Excellent answer, Neil Newman. Okay, moving on, we have our spices. We have some ground cumin. We have ground coriander. Does anybody know what coriander also means? Please enter your answers now. Okay, in addition, we have some cayenne pepper, but actually, I couldn't find cayenne pepper here in Lake Arrowhead, so I'm just using a bit of chipotle pepper. So again, just be creative. You can improvise. If you like it like ay caramba, you could even use jalapeno pepper instead of poblano. Another excellent substitute for poblano pepper, which is a mild pepper called Anaheim. Okay, I also added some oregano, and we have some salt, and we have some pepper. Okay, should we get started, you guys? Yay!
Let's do it, but before you do,
okay.
We have answers. Marcus is on fire.
Marcus McGee, what? Okay. What are his answers?
Cilantro.
Oh, cilantro!
Yes!
Ding, 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 ding. Good job. So,
anything? Are we giving away anything today?
Just excellent tips and a delicious recipe. But I will tell you, tune in on Saturday because we're doing a live stream in conjunction with Melissa's Produce. And we'll be giving away a $100 box of delicious, fresh Melissa's Produce and talking about all those amazing shelf-stable root vegetables and other produce that you should have on hand during these difficult times. Okay? So I think we should get started. I'm going to have Becca cut up these poblano peppers, okay? But first, what we wanna do, if you all have your poblano pepper, hold it up. Okay, ready? I'm gonna slice it in half lengthwise. And then what you wanna do is remove the ribs, like so. Hey, Rita.
Yes, ma'am.
Do we have some new guests that have joined us?
Oh, we have so many new guests.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, this is, I think everybody is feeling so cooped up that they want to cook with Katie.
I understand. I want to cook with myself. Okay, ready?
We have Jennifer Panchenko joining, Cynthia Motters, Phil Dominguez. It's a party.
Hi, everybody. I'm so excited because I've been feeling so lonely. I mean, I love my family, but I've been missing all my friends. Now, one thing I wanted to mention is extremely important to wash your hands, guys. We just washed our hands for about 20 seconds before we started the live stream. But if you are cooking with me today, it's very important that you put your knives down, go to your sink, and wash your hands for at least 20 seconds. Right, Becca?
Mm-hmm.
What song do you like to sing when you wash your hands?
Happy birthday.
Okay. All right. So we remove the seeds, remove the ribs. If you wish to keep the seeds in your pepper, it's going to be a bit spicier. So it's really a personal preference. So we're just going to go ahead and cut this into fine little dices, like so. Now the reason we want all of our ingredients to be about the same size is because then they cook more evenly. Also, when you're cutting with a knife, it's very important that you grasp the handle firmly, like so, like you're shaking the hands of the knife. The other thing you want to bear in mind is you want to protect your fingertips, okay? Like so. All right, I'm gonna just curl my fingertips. I'm gonna slice, slice, slice. Bear in mind, the blunt end, the widest part of the knife is the sharpest. So it's the safest to really focus cutting with this part of the knife, because the sharpest part is actually the safest. Protect your fingertips like so. Okay.
Katie, have you taught Becca how to chop?
I have. She's an excellent sous chef. As a matter of fact, I'm going to make her take over this task. That's why it's great to have kids around. Not only is it fun to cook together, but it's a great way to get the job done. Okay. Yes, also another important tip is do not touch your eyes when cutting peppers. Now let's talk a little bit about the Scoville scale. Does anybody out there know the definition of the Scoville scale?
Oh, I do.
Okay, is that you, Rita, talking?
Do I count?
Okay, you can give me one.
Okay, it's the heat of, it's actually a heat scale, right? Not
it
just
is.
Peppers, but heat.
It is, it's the measurement of the pungence of the pepper. So poblano is considered to be a very, very mild pepper, like an Anaheim pepper. This has about 1,000, it rates about 1,000 on the Scoville scale. Can anybody name one of the hottest peppers on the Scoville scale? Anybody? Anybody? It rhymes with meeper. It's the name of a state that rhymes with meeper. Any answers?
Ghost.
Ghost is one great answer. California Reaper is another. Komodo Dragon. So we're talking about the poblano pepper ranking at about 1,000 on the
Carolina
scale.
Carolina Reaper.
Carolina Reaper. What did I say?
California Reaper.
I'm sorry. Carolina Reaper.
That quarantini is working well.
The quarantini is working really well. All right. So as I was saying, the poblano pepper ranks at about 1,000, whereas some of these hotter peppers, 850,000 to 2 million on the Scoville scale, okay? All right, and because we're making this chili for kids, we're gonna stick with something more mellow, like a poblano. All right, now let me show you guys how to cut an onion like the chefs do, all right? This is an efficient way to cut a white onion. What we're gonna do is I slice one in half. Okay, can you see there, Matthew?
Katie, mm-hmm. While you're slicing, can you also offer any tips for those of us who cry like babies?
Oh, well, you can use...
In like general this. Or when you're cutting onions?
When you're cutting onions. Thank you, Matt.
Because you have a friend, Rita. Yeah, some people say you can actually rub your hands on your faucet before you cut an onion. But I just recommend, or eating bread, eating some white bread may help. But if you're like Rita's husband, Adam, I would suggest having your wife cut onions because I see what an onion can do to you. So anyway, we're just gonna start with half of an onion, which I peeled. All right, Becca, actually, We're going to do 3 poblanos, so keep going. Good job. All right. I'm just going to take my half onion, put it down. Then I'm going to take a knife, and I'm just going to slice through about a quarter of an inch. So I'm going to make some slices through the onion. You see? Everyone see that? Next.
Oh, Bill Fike says wear swim goggles.
Oh, excellent, excellent tip. Bill Fike is a member of our family, and he wears swim goggles when he cuts his onions. Okay, next I'm just going to cut through here. Can you guys see? Mm-hmm. Now I'm just going to go crosswise into the onion. You guys see that? This is a very efficient way to cut onions. Are you okay there, Becca?
Yeah.
All right, be careful. Next, I'm just going to cut through and see, like so. If you're cooking along, if you're cooking along with me, please say I. Please comment, I am cooking along with you, Katie. Okay, there we go. So as you can see here, look at that. Wasn't that cool? Rita, do you feel like you could even do that?
No.
No.
I'll go make Adam do it.
She'll make Adam do it. Okay, ready? There we go. So about a half of an onion yields about 1 cup of chopped onion. Great. All right.
And now, Katie, can you tell us why white onion versus yellow versus red?
You know, it's just a simpler taste than a yellow onion. Yellow onion is a bit more savory, but either one will be fine. Okay. Now I'm just going to help Becca cut these. Another great...
By the way, Becca, you're getting a lot of shout-outs.
All right, let's hear it.
Well, first of all, and I don't think this was directed to Becca, but your brother Billy says, just keep your head out of the way of the vapor.
For the onions.
Oh, okay. Another
or vapor in general.
I'm like,
in general.
I think he means after you eat the chili.
This is a family show, everybody.
Wait,
okay, my brother just wrote in another excellent tip, and that is to keep your nose away from the vapors. And I think this is in particular regard to some of the hotter peppers, such as a bird's eye pepper, which is a Thai pepper. Those are the really tiny peppers you see at the Asian market. Those are super hot, so you gotta make sure you wear rubber gloves. Okay, I believe Allison has joined us as well. Hi, Abby. Rita, do we have any other questions?
No other questions, but you're getting compliments on your sweater.
Becca's getting compliments, or I'm getting compliments?
No, you are. Oh, Mark is enjoying the color.
Thank you so
really
much.
Pops.
Thanks, Mark. All right.
It's called quarantine blue.
Quarantine blue, everybody. Oh, speaking of quarantine, I'm going to have another sip of my quarantini. Now I'm just going to cut up some celery. I sliced the celery in half. Once again, our goal here is to have nice, even pieces. So I sliced it in half lengthwise, and now I'm just chopping it. You see? Now when we're chopping our vegetables, we want to make sure that we use a separate board for meat rather than vegetables. So I always tend to cut your grape. Becca did a round of applause, Rebecca. Okay, wave to everybody. See if I can do an awesome job. All right, so I'm just gonna cut up more celery. Hey, Becca, will you cut up this last stalk of celery?
Mm-hmm.
So I did about three.
Yes, Chef.
I did about 3 stalks of. Wait, okay, be careful. Here, let me do this.
Okay.
First. Once again, we're gonna go lengthwise.
Sorry.
Then maybe why don't you use this knife now and go down? Okay, ready? Now let's talk a little bit about our toppings today. Everybody has their favorite toppings for chili, but what we're gonna use today is some shredded cheese. I just have some Mexican blend cheese here, but you can use any type of cheese that you like. We have some chopped green onions along with some sour cream. We also have some fresh cilantro and some lime juice. Again, lime juice really boosts immunity. It's also really delicious and adds that delicious tart note to your chili. Also, some chopped avocado, okay? Good job, Becca, yay!
Becca, you are getting shout outs. Your cousin Katie says you are the chalk master.
Hey, Katie. And
Lily says, Becca, you're doing a great job chopping.
Two pandas from Abby.
Oh, thank you for the panda.
Okay. Now we're going to start with, actually, hey, Becca, could you get the turkey out from the fridge? Mm-hmm. So today I got some turkey. They actually had it in stock at the store in Lake Arrowhead. And that's the beef. Here's the turkey. I bought some Jennie-O ground turkey. Jennie-O is my preferred brand. Shout out to Nicole Benet in Austin, Minnesota from Hormel. Hope you're watching. We miss you so much. All right, here's my ground turkey. I bought it in a log, people. My husband's making fun of my gestures. The ground turkey, I bought in a log because I wanted to buy extra, but any ground turkey you might have on hand is totally fine. And this is such a delicious recipe. I would buy maybe 3 or 4 packs of ground turkey and just keep some in your freezer so you can make this all week or over the next 2 to 3 or 4 weeks. All right, I'm starting with a nice hot pot. And then to this, I'm gonna add some extra virgin olive oil, about 2 tablespoons. And then to this, I'm gonna add, Becca, maybe you could put the onions in there.
Sizzle, sizzle.
Ooh, sound effects.
Okay, good job. You know what I forgot, you guys? I forgot the garlic, so I'm just going to put you over here. Okay.
Katie, for garlic, do you have to use fresh, or can you use the minced garlic that you can get in the store in the jar?
I'm a big believer in using jarred garlic if you don't have time. I think any resources that are out there that allow you to cook at home are great ones. So either the jarred garlic, or they even sell garlic in tubes, is totally fine. So I'm just gonna, whoops, oh. Never mind. I'm just gonna smash my garlic, and then I'm going to mince it, finally, like so. Again, using the blunt end of the knife. All right, here we go. Rita, tell us about some of our new guests.
Oh, well, we have a lot of new guests, but I actually have a great tip here that I've been waiting to chime in with from the fabulous little Katie Chin, who says instead of sour cream, she uses plain yogurt, plain Greek yogurt, and Ooh. It tastes the same.
Ooh, that's a great tip. My niece Katie Chin, also named Katie Chin, obviously, soon to be Katie Clavette, she likes to use Greek yogurt instead of sour cream, which I think is an excellent substitute. All right, so you want to saute your onions and garlic for about 2 minutes until it becomes translucent and soft. Doesn't it smell good?
Mima can smell it from here.
Mima, I wish you were here, Mima. I would offer you some. All right, next we're gonna add our poblano peppers. You wanna help me, Becca?
Sure.
I'm just gonna go ahead and
add my celery.
I'm gonna add my celery as well.
Okay.
Okay. Good job. There we go. All right, now what I'm gonna do is just saute this for a bit, but I'm also going to push the peppers and the onions to the side a little bit. Next, I'm gonna add our ground turkey meat. Okay, this is about 1 pound. What you want to do is break up the ground turkey with your spatula. You can also use the back of a wooden spoon. So you just want to break that up. And then, hey, moms and dads out there, I would do this part because it requires a little muscle power. Then your kids can help again. Okay? There we go. Next, I'm going to add our spice mix. So this is ground oregano, ground cumin, ground coriander, also known as ground cilantro, some salt and pepper, also some cayenne pepper, or today I'm using chipotle pepper. So what we want to do is we just want to break this up with a spoon like so, okay? Now you could certainly use ground pork for this dish if you wanted to. You could do ground beef. You could do red beans instead of white beans. Again, Beyond Beef, I think, or Impossible Burger is a great alternative if you want to create a vegan version of this dish. Okay. Very good. Now, once we get this going, so what you want to do is you want to keep sautéing this meat until it turns white, which is going to be about 3 minutes. When I'm doing this recipe with pork, I usually cook for about 4 to 5 minutes because you want the pork to be thoroughly seared and cooked through.
Hey, Katie, we have a request for a dish for your next Cooked Up with Katie.
Okay, let's hear it.
Brownies.
Brownies? Who's that
we
from?
We have a request for brownies from Maryam Czar.
Hi, Maryam Czar. We will certainly make some brownies next time. But I was thinking, actually, our next live stream we're scheduling for this Thursday at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time will be entitled, When Life Gives You Lockdown, Make Lo Mein. That's right, folks. I'm going to make a delicious lo mein recipe. It's going to be sort of like everything but the kitchen sink. So whatever veggies you might have on hand or roast chicken that you can just shred up, chilled shrimp, whatever. You can just stick it in that lo mein. But the important thing is learning how to make the delicious Cantonese gravy that we make for.
There's been a request for a dance break by Becca.
Okay,
who,
dance break.
Who requested that? Who requested that?
Your fans, your fans. Come on, quick, quick. Throw something together, freestyle.
Yay, yay, good job. Okay.
Back to the chili.
All right, any other suggestions for future shows, please comment now. Okay, now my turkey has turned white. How does that look, you guys? Does it look good? I'm gonna add our white beans. Ready? I'm gonna add our hominy. Okay. All right, now I'm just gonna toss this till it's combined. All right. Who out there is following along and feels like this is an easy recipe? Let me know. Karen Israel, are you out there? Okay. There we go. All right, so I'm just stirring this till it's combined. Yeah? Okay, excellent. Next, I'm just gonna add 4 cups of chicken broth. Okay. As I mentioned, if you want to create a vegetarian version of this dish, just double up on the meat, double up on the beans and omit the turkey, or use Beyond Meat, or you could even use some tofu, right? That would be delicious. Then you want to turn the heat up to high, okay? All the way. And then we're going to put a lid on it.
Put a lid on it. Oh, Karen's working. She said she'll watch later.
Oh, Karen. Okay, so we're going to let this come to a boil. Once it comes to a boil, we'll turn it to medium. And then you guys are going to let it boil on a medium-low heat for about an hour to an hour and 15 minutes. Then, once the liquid in the chili is reduced and has become evaporated, then turn it to low, to a simmer, for about 10 minutes. But luckily, you guys, through the magic of TV,
I love the magic of TV.
Through the magic of TV, I happen to have, could you grab a spoon, Becca? I made a batch earlier, you guys, today. It was so delicious. I think Becca gave it a 4-star. Oh, I also wanted to mention another thing. This recipe is actually from my cookbook, 300 Best Rice Cooker Recipes. Could you grab it from the dining room table?
Yes.
Or on the living room table. Mm-hmm. I wrote a cookbook about 9 years ago called 300 Best Rice Cooker Recipes, and it's everything you can make in a rice cooker. So for today, I adapted it just for a stovetop. But anyway, it's from this cookbook. So you could also make this recipe in your rice cooker. It's called Dylan's.
How about a crock pot?
Or a crock pot, absolutely. But what I love about this recipe is it doesn't take hours and hours to make. It sits on a boil for about 45 minutes to an hour and 15 minutes, then just a low simmer. So you can make it, you know, like we did today at 11:30 and have it in time for lunch. It was super delicious, especially because we're in Lake Arrowhead, the kids were out sledding today and building a snowman. Okay, so for our chili, let's just dive into our delicious toppings. I'm just gonna add some yummy cilantro. some cheese, green onions. Dylan wanted to put some crushed Fritos on here, so it's really a DIY dish. Whatever you like. A dollop of sour cream. Last but not least, second to last but not least, we're gonna do some avocado cubes. Some delicious fresh squeezed lime juice. I think I'm actually going to slice up some yummy additional peppers on top. How does it look, you guys?
It looks amazing. William Fike says it looks delish.
Ooh, I wish you guys were here. Hi, William Fike and Jean Chin from Atlanta. All right, Becca, you want to take it?
Oh. By the way, Laura Chin of the Chin family wants to know, does the chili freeze well?
Excellent question. I haven't tried it yet, but I think it will. Just don't put the toppings on, you know, first. But maybe we'll give that a try since we've made several batches today of this delicious turkey white bean chili. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Give it a try. Just as good as a mid-afternoon snack. I hope you enjoy your white bean turkey chili. Do you guys have any questions or comments? Please let us know what else you'd like us to make. In addition to our When Life Gives You Lockdown Make Lo Mein recipe on Thursday, I think we're gonna make some Lower the Curve cookies. That's right, Lower the Curve cookies, which will be Nutella cookies with just three other ingredients. Okay, any other comments or questions?
Everybody's saying how good that chili looks. And it's gluten-free. Of course, Lindsay was very excited about that.
Yeah, absolutely. Totally gluten-free. And as I said, an easy way. That was my son Dylan making rabbit ears behind my head.
Well, it is Dylan's favorite chili.
It is. Here, let me show you. Show them. So you guys, when I was writing this cookbook, as many of you may have remembered, because I made you test all these recipes, the twins were about 2 years old. Okay, can you find it? The twins were about 2 years old, and so there was an entire chapter just on risottos, and I made them eat risotto for 2 full weeks. At the end of the 2 weeks, they were sitting in their high chairs going, mac and cheese, mac and cheese, mac and cheese. And even though Dylan was only 2 years old, he took a bite of this chili, and he said, yum. So I named the recipe. That's right. Dylan's favorite chili. Again, you can find this recipe on my blog, chefkatiechin.com. Until then, I hope you guys tune in on Thursday. I miss everybody so much. I know you can see us, but I wish I could see you. Anyway, please let me know on Facebook what other dishes you'd like us to make. We'll see you Thursday for sure for Lockdown Lo Mein. Don't forget to whip up some quarantinis. I wish my son would stop making fun of me. But anyway, miss you all, love you all, be safe, be healthy, and have a great day.